H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Okay, so let's start with our Python programming thing. So what exactly Python programming means? So in this particular course, we are going to learn three important topics. Okay, so when you actually start Python, okay, there are, if you go to what I can say, if you go online and search courses or blogs, okay, so the thing is, it's very confusing out there. So when we have to organize our study, okay, in Python, I will give you three important sections, okay, where you should focus on. Good with that? So let's start with that. So when you start with programming, that is programming in Python, I'll tell you Python programming rather. So Python programming, the first topic is basically Python core. So Python core is something which we start with, okay? So Python core has the basics of Python. Correct. So we'll talk about it in more area. Then the second topic which we worked on, is Python web. So Python has a web framework. Okay, actually Python has many web frameworks. Okay, it's not one, it's many. So out of that, the most important is Django. But we'll add that. And then finally, Python is very useful in machine learning and AI. Okay. So out of that, we will be getting an introduction to machine learning concepts. But with that, so that is Python ML. Now, of course, entire machine learning concept is not covered in this particular course. It's a different course altogether. But in machine learning concepts, what is machine learning and what are the different aspects on softwares of Python or libraries of Python are being used, that we are going to discuss in this particular course. But with that, so within Python core, we are learning basics, okay, and then we are also learning Python. So we'll start with all the, what I can say, programming concept. Okay, so we start with OOPS, that is object oriented programming concepts. Okay, so OOPS concept is the second one. Good with that. We also start, okay, we also have, very simple concept like classes and objects, so class and objects, what with that. And then, so these three concepts are basic concepts. Okay, so even I can have a subtopic of this one, and then you can move this to basics. Okay, you can move this to basics. So these are the basic concepts of Python. Okay, one more thing we're gonna actually do is we will be seeing a little bit advanced stuff. Okay, so in advanced, then we will start with operators. Okay, even operator actually generally go in basics. And here though, you will find controls and loops. Okay, so within that you have multiple types of loops and all. Okay, so I just move it here. Then we will add multi-threading. That is when you are having a parallel processing engines. What with that? So we also have something called file handling, where we will deal with files. So file handling. Okay. And then XML processing. So XML or JSON. So I'll just say JSON because JSON is the latest one. So JSON processing. Okay. these are advanced stuff. Okay, even controls and loops goes in basics. So these are advanced stuff. So you can actually have something called some topic with advanced. Then move this to advanced. Okay, one more thing we have here is Python DB. So how to interact with DB? Good with that. So when you learn all these things, what we do is we create a project. Okay, we create a project and we will use all these concepts. Okay, so we'll create actor management, employee management project. Okay, so we'll create a screen. Okay, we'll have some fields there. Okay, screen creation will happen here though. So we'll create background actually. So background services for that. So we'll create a simple project where the database is used. Okay, you can save the details with the help of JSON. But with that, or we might be reading a file and then use to store that into DB. So we will be using all these concepts, okay, for actual Python project. Okay, so that will help us to understand the concepts in practical way. Good with that. In Python web, okay, so there are more topics here, but then I'm this is enough. In Python web, we will be learning Django. So Django has internally a lot of other modules. Okay, so I'm not going to add that here, but this is Django. And then in Python ML, okay, we are going to learn three important things. So one of the most important things we are going to start with is NumPy. So NumPy is a library which is used for numerical Python. Okay, so it's statistical data analysis library. And one more thing is we're gonna add pandas. Pandas are nothing but panel data. So NumPy and Panda are basic libraries which you are going to learn in this particular course. So this is all like mind map of entire course. Okay, I will be giving you this, don't worry. Okay, so this particular thing will be exported and given it to you. Now what are the tools we are going to use for this particular course? Good with that. So let's go ahead and add a topic into it. Any questions up to this point? Everything good? All fine? If you have any, just let me know. So what are the tools you need? And today we are going to start with that. Okay, so we're gonna set up the systems. We will be ready for Python installation. So first and most important tool basically is use Python itself. So you need to download and install Python. So let's go ahead and add that. So how do we actually do that? Okay, so I'll be saying Python good with that. So downloads and go to Python, the latest version download for Python 3.7.4. okay, please do that. Cool up to this point. So if you open this, you will be able to see that this is a URL for Python download. Okay, so anyway, this map is for you only, so don't worry about that. So first tool use is Python itself. So now how do you do that? So go here, download, and click on this. Okay, this will be a single exe file. Okay, that is an installer on your machine. So if you're using Mac, use Mac version. If you're using Windows, use Windows version. So once you download that, I'll show you how it looks like. It's recommended to create a Python folder in your computer. Okay, so please do that. Okay, and install your Python in that particular place only. Okay, so here you go. So you will be seeing an application like this. So Python 3.7.2.exe. So I have 3.7.2. You can download 3.7.4. No harm in that. So you will see something like this. Okay, and after that, you're going to double click this, which will start installation of that particular software. Okay, so it will be installing this Python. So for that also, I will recommend that you install Python in C and in your root folder and create a capital Python folder and where you will install it. Okay, so that will be really easy for you. Okay, to analyze or like get the Python path set. Okay, so what is Python path? We're gonna see that. Good with that. So that is your first recommendation. Okay, so I will add that in notes. So you download the latest version. Okay, second thing is, what you do is you basically create capital Python folder. It's not mandatory, it's just recommended. Okay, so capital Python folder and install Python latest version into it. Okay, that's it. There is no other things are needed. Cool with that. So that is your Python software, correct? Okay, how do we use that? We will see. Okay, how do we test whether this is complete installation or not? Okay, so we will see that when we install other softwares. Now second thing you really need is, so today you are going to set all these things, okay, along with me. Second things you need is eclipse.org. So go ahead and download Eclipse. Okay, so I'll just add that in our mind map. That is eclipse.org. Or you will see Eclipse and then add the notes. Okay, whatever. It doesn't matter. So eclipse.org, directly go there, click on download, and you're gonna get softwares. Okay, download packages, and you can download the latest version of Eclipse, which is Eclipse Photon, I guess, or Orion, whichever is the latest. So go ahead and download that. So Eclipse IDE for enterprise Java developers. Okay, yeah. Here you go, and that's for Python. So I'm adding that in the map also. Oops. What? Okay, so that is Eclipse. Now Eclipse is not an installer. Eclipse just a dump. So when you install Eclipse, you will get a file in a zip format, just like this, Eclipse, and then you can get the zip file like this. It's a huge zip file. It's like 350 MB or something. And then you just have to unzip that. Okay, so I just did that, and you can see the file. Okay, so after unzipping, it will be looking at this. Okay, and then you're gonna start this eclipse.exe, okay, and click on it. So I just give you some time. Please go ahead and complete that particular operation. So go ahead and download Eclipse. We'll set that up for you, okay, and then proceed further. So please click on the latest Eclipse, which is Eclipse IDE for enterprise Java developer. Depending on your operating system, doesn't matter where you are. Okay, so you have Mac, Windows, Linux, okay. So just download that. Okay, it will be 350 MB. It will take a little bit of time. Okay, and after that, just unzip that folder. You will see this. Once you see this, just confirm on chat box. Once you have that, I'm going to start that Eclipse. Okay, and meanwhile, I'll also tell you which is the other software we need. So I'm starting Eclipse. Now the next software we need is PyCharm. Okay. So I'm adding a new tool again. So here you go, add a topic, that is PyCharm. Okay, so it comes from the JetBrain. Okay, it's very or highly used no, you can download Eclipse and unzip that particular zip file. The Eclipse is not an installer, as I told you, so it is just a zip file, so unzip that. How do we unzip? Just right click and extract. I'll show you. So any zip file, right? So whichever zip file you are getting, just right click, extract all. If you have 7-zip, then use that. Or if you don't have it, you can use extract all. Okay, in extract all, you have to mention the folder. So I just mentioned, okay. So if I mention it like Eclipse, for test, okay, so this is just for testing, right? So that will be like, it will be extracted in this particular folder. Okay, it's gonna take some time, it is a huge library. Okay, so I'm canceling that because I already have one. Okay, so it will be extracted like this, right? I'm deleting that, just I don't want to add more confusion. I have a lot of versions of Eclipse anyway. So once you have that Eclipse ready, okay, once you have the Eclipse downloaded and you created a folder and then right double click this one, okay, you will get this particular pop-up. Okay, so detailed video of like how do we set up Eclipse, okay, it's already there, so don't worry, I'll be sharing that. So this particular course, there are a lot of tools, utilities, things which you are using which are non-Python. So for that, I created the videos and it's in public domain. So I just published it on YouTube and I'll show you where to go for that. Okay, so let me quickly jump there. And okay, so that's the channel, okay, which actually I don't recommend anybody to subscribe and all, just watch the videos. I'm not going to monetize that channel anyway. This is for students only. So I just gave you the link. Okay, it has a lot of awesome videos for you. Okay, so there are a number of things. It's not only about like Python, it's also like for interview, four tips for talking the recent project interviews, what you do, myths, okay, installing setting ActiveMQ for Java installation, a lot of awesome stuff. So setting Eclipse and JDK, okay, so this is a video you should actually watch, okay, and use that. I started this kind of stuff in recently only, so you can see that I just in August only I uploaded this kind of videos because I really don't want to spend time there. Okay. So that is a video for Eclipse setup, and there is one more video for Python setup. So setting up Python in Eclipse, it's called as PyDev. Okay. Although I am showing you the video, I am also showing that on the screen, so don't worry about that. But these are the two important videos you should watch. Okay, coming back. Coming back on my Eclipse, okay. So here you go. So this is a standard look of Eclipse, okay. And in here, you have to download one plugin. Okay, I have explained that in the video also. You have to download a plugin, and what does plugin mean? Plugin is additional capability in Eclipse. So Eclipse is by default created for Java. So in industry, what happened is when people started shifting from Java to Python, so a lot of people were uncomfortable using Python's IDE. So they started using Python's plugin in Eclipse itself so that they have a comfortable environment at least. Okay, so new programming language but comfortable environment. So that's why it's very popular to use Eclipse for Python. Okay, it's actually number two. So now for adding a plugin of Python in Eclipse, you have to go to help and reach to Eclipse marketplace. Okay, so just click on it and it will start a pop-up. It will show you Eclipse Marketplace. Marketplace is nothing but, this is like, what are the plugins available for you. So there are awesome plugins around, but out of that we are going to use only one, and that one is called as pydev. Okay, so go ahead and type pydev here. So pydev and search that particular thing. So once you search, you will be able to find that one. So pydev, Python IDE for Eclipse, and then latest version of Eclipse, and you can see how many downloads we have. Okay, so why this is so popular is, if you just compare first and the second result, this is 40,000 downloads, okay, and this is 1.2 million downloads. Simple as that, correct? So it is used so widely that these many downloads have already happened. So pydev is Python IDE for Eclipse, and go ahead and download. So there will be an install button here. I have already installed it, so you have to click on install and it will install it in your Eclipse, and you are done with that. Okay, don't try any other things. Okay, see the number of downloads and just compare it, like how many users of pydev we have. So it's a very stable and very efficient plugin. Okay, so this is enough for today. So for about Eclipse. So now moving ahead. So, and entire thing will be anyway covered in that video. So please watch that. Okay, it has everything there. Now moving to the next software, which is PyCharm. So PyCharm, come back here. I'll close this guy and come into PyCharm download. And PyCharm comes from JetBrains. You don't need Eclipse and PyCharm at the same day. Okay, so you can start with Eclipse or start with PyCharm, whichever you are comfortable with, doesn't matter. Okay, so I will be anyway giving you guidance in both areas. We will generally start with PyCharm, so go ahead and download PyCharm also. Okay, so in PyCharm you have like selections of operating system, but before that you should know the difference between professional and community version. You do not need to download this. Okay, so this is a trial version for 30 days, okay, and it is a professional version, which is paid version. We don't need that. We need community version for Python development. So we are actually doing pure Python development, so we are not adding any stuff here. So that's why we need a simple community edition. So go ahead and download that, so that nobody will ask you any kind of license fee in future. Good with that. So click on download and it's going to start downloading the stuff for you. Okay, if you want to, you can just provide email addresses. So it is 252 MB. okay, so I have already downloaded that. I'll show you how it looks like. So I'll go back to my Python folder, and it is Python community, and then I have something from 2018, but actually downloaded on 14 March 2019. Okay, so download that and then you click on it, it will start installing the stuff. So this is again an installer which just need your like click buttons. Okay, so next, and it will be done. So you just have to show them like where exactly you need to install that. So installing PyCharm, you have to provide which folder you want to install it to. Okay, then next it will ask like what are the things you need. So you know, 64-bit launcher. Okay, so do you need anything else? Okay, do you want to add a JRE also? Okay, nothing like that. So just click on next and it will install the PyCharm on your machine. So I'm not going to do that, okay, because I already have PyCharm, but this is what it is. Okay, that's it. Yes, and close that stuff. So once you install, I installed it in this particular folder again in capital Python, and you have this JetBrains installed here. It also gives a start option. So if you just add PyCharm, so you will be seeing this app. Okay, it will also add this app on your in your computer, so you can just click on it and PyCharm will start. So there is a different look from Eclipse perspective. Eclipse is like all white, and but the section like Project Explorer section and everything will be looking very similar to that. So let's start PyCharm and see how it looks like. So I'm giving you a link. and also adding this particular link in our notes. Okay, that's a PyCharm. Okay, so let PyCharm start. We already clicked on it. Now the next tool, or it's not a tool, it's a database we need. So for this course, now remember that we do have a database connectivity to Python. Okay, so we are learning an end-to-end Python here. So we are creating an application from web, from screen to database, and from database to screen. So you should know all that aspect. So you also need MySQL. So I'll also recommend you to download MySQL, okay, well in advance. Okay, again, there is a YouTube channel and there's a video for that. Good with that? So I'll be showing you how to download MySQL and from where to download. So I'll go to downloads. And I'll also add a tool here. MySQL, correct? So MySQL is here, and then you need to download that from. So remember that you have to download. So don't go for enterprise again. We don't need enterprise edition. What we need is a community edition, and you know how the software tricks your mind. See, the enterprise edition like title is so big and everything. And at the last, you will see MySQL community GPL download. So this is what you need. You don't need anything else. Okay. So go to that particular topic. Community downloads. Okay, so out of that you will need, so basically everything. So MySQL installer for Windows, just click on this particular option, it will install everything for you. Okay, so this is it. So I'm giving you the link and adding that link in our mind map. Okay, so that's it. So now you go ahead and download. Any of this is fine, okay? And it shows like it's 32 bit. It's not 32 bit, don't worry about that. Okay, so it will be 64 only. So now the nomenclature for that is like a little bit different, but that's okay. So whichever you download doesn't matter. So this MSI file is basically, MSI installer is basically like it will give you this 18 MB file. And when you actually start installing it, it go ahead and download the stuff from internet. And this one is a complete package, so it doesn't need any download further. So if you have a slower internet connection, I will recommend the second option. Okay, so that it will download everything and install quickly. If you have a good internet connection, like I have Comcast, so like you can go for this option. This is also fine. Good with that? So that is your PyCharm. So once you install that, okay, you will see PyCharm like this, and I'll recommend you to actually use PyCharm. So we're gonna start our journey with PyCharm only. Good with that. So now our task is to complete the installation. Okay, so this particular mind map will be is created for you only. So our task is to complete the installation of tools, setting up of the tools. Okay, and one more important thing is setting up Python. So your Python should be installed, okay, well in advance, so that we will start the project. So that we are going to learn in the next class, that is tomorrow. Good with that. So tool setup is the first, and then from next class we are going to start object-oriented programming concepts. Okay, so what is programming in the first, because we do have people in our course, we do have people in our journey, we do not have any programming background. So for them, we will be first understanding what are the different programming concepts. Okay, and then we will proceed further with object-oriented programming concepts and how Python fits in. Okay, so there are different ways like structural programming and object-oriented programming, and fortunately Python fits in both ways. Okay, so you can go with structural programming in Python or object-oriented. So I actually worked in both areas. I started my career in Python batch, which is kind of structural, but then now I'm actually working in Python Django. So which is web-based Python, and I'm developing microservices with the help of Django. Django is really good for microservices. We'll talk about what is microservice anyway. So what are the activities and what are the tasks for today? So today, first thing first is you have to install Python. Second is Eclipse. Third is PyCharm and MySQL. So MySQL is not mandatory, at least for a week, but then you need Python and PyCharm for sure. Okay. All the videos are there in the YouTube channel already. So you can just see the YouTube channel, okay? There are a lot of awesome stuff I'm adding there, okay? So day by day, it's getting enriched, okay? And again, there is no restriction on you to subscribe or unsubscribe. There is nothing to monetize, okay? This is for students forever. So you can keep that link forever or you can subscribe it. It's on you. Good with that. So that is, these are the three primary activity you want to do. And after that, in next class, we're going to discuss the basics of programming. So what exactly programming is really mean. Good with that. So let me stop here. I'll export this thing. Okay. I'll do that and then send it to you. Okay. So that you will have this particular view of the course and what are the different things needed. Can I shift this somewhere here below that? Below will be good. So shift it below this. Okay. Now, that looks cool, right? So one-sided stuff. Cool. So I'll be sharing this particular mind map with you. Okay. And we're going to create lot of mind maps like this. Good with that. So let's stop here and let's continue to the next class, which is alternate day. So currently we started on Wednesday. We have alternate day classes. So we have Friday. And after that, there will be a Monday, and then Monday onwards, we are starting a regular classes every day. Okay. So this particular course takes 25 to 30 hours. So please be ready for a lot of learnings. Okay. And let me tell you some statistics. The course completion rate. Okay. So for us, so in industry standard, when you go for any other websites or any other courses, the course completion rate for other courses is around 20%. And for us, the course completion rate is around 70%. So we gonna complete the courses, okay, for sure. Good with that? For all, what with all of you, that's what matters. So students are not completing the courses. So do we need, if you need help in download, how do we contact you? Yes. So you have my email address always. And the second important thing is I'm going to share a link for my Python Achievers group. Okay, so there is a Telegram channel. Do you know Telegram? Okay, so there is a Telegram group we created for Python Achievers. Okay, it has of all my Python students. Okay, join that with the link. Okay, and you can ask any question to me anytime. Okay, and you have other students also. So those students also help you. Good with that. So these are my students. Actually, I have a bigger group, okay, which is like having all kind of students together. I will not add you as of now there because there the discussions are very advanced. Okay, so they discuss about like what's going on in microservices area or AI area. I will not add you there. I will not confuse you more. I will add you in Python Achievers group where we have recent students, okay, very recent, like probably last 6 months. Okay, so they are also exploring the stuff. So you will be part of that group. Good with that. So let me share that link with you right away so that you can join the Telegram group. It's just like WhatsApp group, by the way. It's very similar to WhatsApp group. Telegram is a very nice software. Okay, you can actually create a group of 200,000 total people. Okay, that's completely possible. So I have my Python Achievers group. So, and I will be sending this to all students. So we have like 7 to 8 people in this particular course. So I'll be sending that to all. So whenever I add a new video or whenever I have any other session, okay, which is not related to Python, but then important for you, I generally publish this in my Telegram channel. Okay. So go ahead and join because I'm taking a session on, new integration techniques. Okay. Or I'm taking a session on resume building, or I'm taking a session on how to attain a telephonic interview. Okay. So whenever we have such things, I generally publish that in our Telegram channel so that everyone can hop on and learn the stuff. Good with that. So this is the way to reach out to me. Only condition is do not post personal one-to-one questions. Okay. So whatever questions you have, type it in your chat box. Type in this particular group. Okay. So I am there, I will be only answering the questions in the group. Okay, if you ping me personally, I'm not going to answer anything. Okay, see, your one question is solves answers or gives answers to many people. Okay, that's the reason we are following that particular thing. So you can join this particular Telegram channel, okay, to ask questions anytime, or you can drop me an email if there are any personal or one-to-one questions. Good with that? So let's stop here and let's continue to the next class. You will receive this particular mind map, okay, as soon as this class is done. Good with that? And the recording of this video. Cool. So let's stop here and continue to the next class. Thanks a lot, everyone. Good night.